Okay, moving on to the last and final segment of today's show. I wanted to talk a little bit about some major, and when I say major, I mean major move that happened in college basketball during this past week. And I know that over the last week as well, usually on Wednesdays, that's the day I record and talk about college basketball on this podcast. You know, with the new schedule, we're not going to be able to have a full podcast fully dedicated to college basketball. And I'm also going to be continuing my head coach power rankings. So by the time we get to the start of next college basketball season, don't worry, I've only done three conferences. I will be doing the other three Power Six by the time the season starts back up. Don't worry about that. But I wanted to talk a little bit about the freshman Makur Maker. If you missed it, he's a top like 20 recruit. He's like he's about 7 feet tall, super athletic, and he announced that he will be attending Howard. And you're thinking, Howard? For a top 100 kid? Why Howard? Is that even a school? Like what is that? Howard literally has not been basketball relevant in a while, and I mean a long, long time. And you know, to the casual college basketball fan, Howard could seem like kind of a weird destination, a weird choice for a kid that is as highly regarded of a prospect as Makur Maker. And I want to talk a little bit about this because if you didn't know, Howard is one of the historically black colleges and universities, and Mikey Williams, who is a top five recruit in next year's class, he was really the first one that I heard kind of talking about this and possibly doing this after everything that went down with George Floyd in Minnesota. And I gotta be honest with you, when I first heard that, I kind of just looked at it and laughed. I was like, all right, like, it's good for him to consider it. We also know that recruits in the past, sometimes what they like to do, I don't know if it's called like a courtesy or what, but it's basically what it means is that if you're getting recruited by a Duke or a Kentucky or all the Blue Bloods, whatever, and you see that an Ivy League school like a Harvard or a Yale is interested in you, then you'll usually put Harvard or Yale on like your top five, even though deep down everyone knows that you're not going to be going there. I remember Wendell Carter was one of the guys that happened with. But going back to Howard and Makur Maker, I think this is really good from a basketball perspective, like, or not even a basketball perspective, but from a college basketball perspective and what is good for the sport. And I think in college basketball these days, this is a conversation and a good topic to bring up, because when you look at it, like, we need things that are good for college basketball right now. The fact is, I don't think the G League is going to effectively end college basketball like a lot of people are saying that it may, but at the same time, we need something to draw casual viewers in. And I'm not saying the casual viewer isn't going to be watching 30 Howard games a season just to watch Makur Maker. Like, I get it. But at the same time, I do think this will at least be something from a perspective of, all right, I know a college basketball player. This past year, I hate to say it, but let's face facts. If you were to ask just a regular person before March Madness would have started, which we know it obviously didn't, but if you were to ask one person, right, just like a casual fan, name one player in college basketball, and I'm not talking about like sport, like people that have no interest in sports at all, I'm talking about people that watch the NBA and watch the NFL but may not really get into college basketball until March Madness starts. I'm talking about those kind of people, and I think Makur Maker is one of these guys where even no matter how it goes, like, he's going to have an impact, and people are going to want to watch him just at the least to see how he does. And that's a good kind of development into this question, and something I want to say about Makur Maker. Once again, I think from just a culture perspective, from an outsider's perspective, like, the fact that he was the first ever, like, top 20 recruit to commit to a historically black college and university, that's awesome. And it's good for the sport, it's good for our culture, it's good for this country, and it would be cool to see other five-star recruits possibly follow in his direction. But when you look at Howard, and Howard basketball, to be a little more specific, last year, this team not only was bad, but they were 4-29, went 1-15 in their conference, which also happens to be probably one of the two or three worst conferences in college basketball. And their best player last year, who averaged 18.5 points a game, Charles Williams, will not be returning. He was a senior, and he graduated. So here's the thing. As much as Makur Maker is going to play for Howard, and as cool as it's going to be to watch him, and as much interest as Howard's games might have, realistically, do you see this team winning the MEAC, their conference, and making the NCAA tournament? Because I'll tell you what, if he were to go to another historically black college or university, let me pull up here the 2019 MEAC standings, and I'll give you an example to prove my point, because I'll fully admit I was not really locked into the MEAC conference and all their basketball games last year. Usually the only MEAC games I watch are in the NCAA tournament. I know Lavelle Moton, the head coach of North Carolina Central, he's done a really good job there. Okay, but just to, you know, give an example, North Carolina Central 13-3 last year. NCA&T 12-4, Norfolk State 12-4. And I understand that when you compare those schools to Howard, and directly when you ask why would he go to Howard instead of any of those schools, when in basketball Howard went 1-15 last year. And the reason is, a big appeal to Howard is the academic perspective of things and the academic side of things. And Howard is one of the best academic schools in the country. There's no doubt about it. But at the same time, I hate to say it, odds are Makur Maker is going to be a one and done, right? So it's cool to have a good relationship with that kind of school, but it's not like he's going to be getting a degree from Howard. That's number one. Number two, when you look at it, the only other possibility I could see in regards to the question of can the five-star recruit committing to a MEAC school, or an HBCU school, I should say, like, is Makur Maker and everything that goes down with him now, is that going to have an effect on the future of this possibly happening again? Because I'll totally admit it. Even when Makur Maker was putting Howard and speculating about possibly going to an HBCU school, I didn't expect it to actually happen. And going into his announcement, you know, leading up to his announcement, I didn't believe it until I see it. But the bottom line is this, and I feel like we have to all realize this and kind of look ourselves in the mirror and just say, this kid, Makur Maker, actually picked to attend Howard University, a school that went 1-15 in its conference last year and 4-29 overall last year. He selected to go to Howard University instead of Duke when he could have went, instead of Kentucky because he went, like, UCLA. Like, he went to Howard over all those schools. And my question is, in terms of can this happen again, it's this. Makur Maker at Howard is going to put up fantastic numbers. I don't think anyone's going to deny that. He'll average like 22 points a game. He's going to be much taller than everyone else in the MEAC. Because here's the other thing. There's a big difference, and I don't know how many college basketball fans listening to this show realize this. There's a big difference between playing in the MEAC and playing in Conference USA, for example. Conference USA and the MEAC are both mid-major leagues, but Conference USA has had some big men that have gone pro. They've had some, you know, wings that are former top 100 recruits. When you look at Charles Bassey from Western Kentucky there right now, William Lee, you know, guys like that. And when you look at the MEAC, they haven't even been close to sending a player ever to the NBA. Well, I don't want to say ever, but you guys know what I mean. Like, within the last 10 to 15 years since I've started watching college basketball, the MEAC has never really come close to getting a player from one of their programs to the NBA. And obviously, Makur Maker is going to change that. But my question is this. Let's say he averages on Howard, once again, like 22-10, ridiculous numbers. And Howard is like 17-17, finishes in the middle of the road of the MEAC, which I think is very possible when you also consider, once again, the fact that they were awful last year, lose their best player, and as good as Makur Maker is, do we really think he's going to be able to lead a team that went 4-29 last year directly to the top of his league? Maybe, but here's the other thing about Maker and his game. He's more of a project. I've heard all the tools are there physically. Like, he's going to be a really good NBA player. He'll be a good college basketball player as well. But at the same time, when you look at it, I don't know if he's best fit and best equipped for the role of just being the alpha dog and that team eventually becoming successful. I'm not going to believe that happening until I see it. And historically, my problem is, even if Makur Maker puts up, like, even if he has a ridiculous season and averages, I don't know, 30 points a game at Howard, and from a record perspective, win-loss, it's the same thing. I don't think his draft stock is going to, like, rise if he puts up crazy numbers. Because there's an argument to be made that he's playing against kids half his size, and he should be doing that. So it's going to be very interesting to see how this all breaks down. Once again, my main observations from this were, it's cool to see a player do this. I personally never thought it would actually happen. But at the same time, I don't think from a pure basketball perspective, this is such like a huge deal and a record, you know, like something we should be freaking out about. Like, to be honest, I would be surprised if I see another player go to an HBCU school, a top, you know, 10 kid go to an HBCU school again. Maybe I'm wrong, you know, and Makur Maker just has a sick year, leads Howard to a great, you know, season and leads them to the NCAA tournament. Maybe I am wrong, but at the same time, what I'll say is this, man, he's going to have a lot of ball possessions. He's going to have a lot of shots to take, and Howard just went from a team that literally half the country didn't even know existed last year and went 4-29 overall in the MEAC. And now for a lot of people, they're going to be watching Howard games just to see this kid play.